got all sorts of fighting to do.
Ah, see, he is singing the entire end final boss music. Good. That's the song that plays when you fight the Megalith.
Okay. So, we're going to be playing on normal.
Normal?
Level up difficulty suitable for average players.
Is this the beginning of this game?
Yes. This is the opening cutscene now.
So this is normal, so there's not going to be any. So there's not going to be any super weapon.
And in turn, how that cannon brought more.
Echo.
An abstract idea, nothing more than a show on TV.
Oh, I see what's happening. That was me.
As a child, yeah. I only saw it as something that happened in some faraway land. Until that final day of summer. One day, while on my way to school, I looked up in the skies. A sound like distant
Boots
thunder.
Accidentally trapped us in a time loop.
In the blue skies far above
me. He's still trapping us.
Circles around the crazy we have to watch lights. The Shura East Combat 4 forever.
How are we still doing that?
A battle in the
actually,
blue
I don't
skies far away. I could not tear my gaze away
from
him.
Doing your dishes?
I was feeding my cat.
Why are you feeding dishes to your cat?
He's very picky eater, so he needs to prepare a 7-course meal for us.
He only eats the dishes. The
sky. Yeah. One flame your steak tartare, Sir Gary. Spewing orange Sir Gary to crash by the cape.
Gary Christmas Gumdrops.
The same cape where my family lived.
Yes, I remembered your cat's full name. That's kind of first name.
Okay, so this kid's just died because a plane crashed into their house.
The victor circled around
plane
to
start flying.
The kill.
And that's when Ace, that's when Larry Ace Combat decided that he would have his revenge on planes.
I will never forget this.
So he's got like the memory of that plane burned in.
The Allies retreated across
the
ocean. In order to destroy all planes, I must become a plane.
I think that was pretty much the plot of Electrosphere.
Yeah, that was the last game, yeah, where people became the plane.
Yeah, it's not far off.
That was the end of Michael Jackson's Moonwalker.
Yeah, I was on board until he turned into a car. That was weird.
First mission, sitting duck.
No, park. Do you get to play as the duck?
4 years after the planetfall of the Ulysses 1994.
In Minnesota, it's called sitting gray duck. Asteroids.
Right.
The Erujin weapon of mass destruction was originally built to shoot down asteroids. Upon discovering its potential as an anti-aircraft weapon, the Erujins ruled the skies over the mainland. The ISAF's attempts to destroy Stonehenge through airstrikes failed. As a result, strategic positions on the mainland were lost. This in turn forced ISAF to evacuate from the east coast to North Point. ISAF GHQ is regrouping its remaining combat forces at North Point. However, the Erujins control most parts of the mainland, and they have forward-deployed bombers to Wrigley Air Base, a former ISAF facility. This bomber force will attempt to deal a lethal blow to the ISAF at North Point from this strategic position.
This game takes place in 2004, so no YouTube.
Okay, but, Revenge of the Sith was in movie theaters. Effective immediately. See, what else was going on?
That was 2005, also Trap Sprung, I know.
Well, this is the strange real universe. It might have come out in 2004.
What a dark, dark universe this is. On to targets at North Point.
Our defense forces are extremely weak at this point.
The hallmark of these Ace Combat streams starts with me, which is I'm totally lost as to who
is mission critical. Just
doing what? I get the Erujins and ISAF, and there's Erujins have Stonehenge.
ISAF is us, Erujins them.
Okay.
Right now they're about to bomb a defenseless airstrip. We're going to intercept them.
So what country are they the stand-in for? Because Yuzha is America, right?
Okay, so yeah, pretty straightforward. It's like a traditional first mission in Ace Combat games is you just have to shoot down a bunch of slow-moving bombers.
Hold on, my My cat's banana Foster is almost ready.
Good lord, your cat eats good.
It's bananas Foster?
Yeah, yeah.
It's like
no,
Sergeant's
it's
Major.
Banana.
Attorneys okay. General.
This is a cat, he can't eat two more than one banana. Come on.
So at the start, we only have the choice of one aircraft, which is the F-4E Phantom.
All right.
4E.
Do you know anything else about this particular airplane? The history, perhaps, airplane?
It was used as a low-level, fast-moving attack aircraft during the Vietnam War.
All right.
It is engineering proof that given enough thrust, even a brick can fly.
Ooh. No, I remember that from Dumbo.
Yeah.
Operation Dumbo Drop.
So, yeah, when this plane was made, they're like, wow, this plane is huge. And it's really big. And so they're like, okay, well, we'll just have to make the largest engines. And now it flies, and it's awesome.
The 50s car design.
Yes.
You're going to get in the sky one way or the other. Goddamn.
There's no replacement for displacement. Your call
sign is Mobius 1. Well, if you add more metal, it's going to be more safe and better.
Now, the soundtrack to this game is really badass, so if anyone wants to listen to it, victory sure would be nice. Pretty good.
These are F5Es off to the right. Breaking off. Our job is straight ahead.
What system was it? Wait, no, I'm gonna guess PS2.
Yeah, this is PS2. This is where the series.
I don't even ask. I can look at the amount of pixelation to figure it out.
This is where the series really hit its stride. Is PS2.
This is the first PS2 one.
Yep.
Well, I'm gonna launch a competing stream and play PS4.
That'd be quite a feat, actually.
See how many people are gonna tune into that.
Can the PS4 emulate PS1 games?
It can for sure.
Is it like available in the store?
There's a very limited number of games.
There was just PS3.
Well, the PSP and the Vita would play PS1 games. So would the PS3.
Actually, like looking at emulation something a lot. So the thing is, the PS3 originally had just the original PS3 had just a PS2, like the PS2 architecture, just shoved into it. So we could
Right.
And then they took that out.
It turns out that was needlessly expensive.
Yeah, but the thing is, the PS3 can still play PS1 games because like circuit, the motherboard, whatever. Guts that could run a PS1 are useful for other parts of the PlayStation, I believe. So it already has that in there. Like it's like a kind of
like OS level.
Yeah, like something like that. Not relevant side note, but that's why the 3DS can emulate like Game Boy Advance games. Because, or at least it could emulate Game Boy Advance games with all the extra stuff on it, like Nintendo wanted, because the processor is basically just in like an upgraded, overclocked, whatever. It's the same processor as that system, it's just like upgraded.
Okay, that's one mission down. Thanks to your efforts,
the enemy bomber strike was get him, and now we get to see the airplane arrows. Yay!
Yep. Look at how efficient they are.
I say it's actually really impressive that Microsoft has done like backwards compatibility on their games, because the architecture between the Xbox and the Xbox 360 is so vastly different.
Yeah. Well, they worked at that for a long time. Like
it was a Motorola processor that they had in the Xbox.
The war seemed to unfold in the blink of an eye. I don't remember exactly when the forces from the West occupied my town.
Also,
I was too busy
me.
Scanning the skies day after day, waiting for Yellow 13 to reappear.
It's So is Yellow 13 the one that the kid wants to get plane revenge on?
Before yep. I knew it.
Yeah, I got
he was the guy who shot down the plane that crashed
the
into his,
they taught us at school.
In his house.
Yeah.
Our friend, the local sheriff, disappeared and was replaced by foreign MPs. In the beginning,
this is
some people
very
secretly tuned
acting.
Into broadcasts from North Point on their parabolic antennas.
PlayStation 2 voice
acting. They were able to get. Yeah.
But as time passed, the broadcast no longer came in. Maybe the satellites were destroyed. All non-military computer networks were shut down.
Oh God, they turned
gasoline
off all IT.
Gasoline rationed to civilians.
What a hell world we live in.
Though we lived in the 21st century, we were reduced to using crystal radios
like a,
and horse-drawn carts.
Like a Slate podcast or something. You're listening to the slow burn, Arugia.
I moved in with my uncle in town, who used to be a taxi driver. Out of gasoline and out of work.
This is definitely the voice of
my
one of the localization
did
team.
But to drown himself in drink.
Yeah.
I earned my keep by playing the harmonica in the town bar.
I've been playing a little bit of Resident Evil 2, the new one. And a mild spoiler.
I'd play for Selenocki.
Well, Toast doesn't want to be spoiled on the game at all.
And use the money to support my uncle and myself.
Well, it's not the story. Just
my
like,
uncle trash talked the barkeep to cater to the enemy soldiers.
Yeah, I want to talk about the box.
But he never refused the money I brought home.
I haven't looked at the box. The box. That's how much I.
Right, well, then I
for myself.
Okay,
damn,
fine.
I had a crush.
Jimmy,
my only daughter.
Jimmy, later you and I can talk about Resident Evil 2 though, because I've played through.
Okay. All right.
That's a done deal.
Let's do that.
Another day passed.
Yeah.
Yet still no sign of the fighter plane Yellow 13 in the skies above our town.
I don't think this kid realizes why he can't see Yellow 13 above the town. It's because there are no. If he's in occupied territory, then there's no aerial battles there. There's going to be aerial battles at the front lines.
That would make sense.
Yeah. So we're going to save.
Took his house. That's not very nice. We're going to get that guy.
Well, the way Ace Combat stories kind of happen is you, the character, is not directly in any of the cutscenes. It's just like stuff that's going on while you're doing your thing.
Yeah, but I'm assuming that your character's at least in the same country as this guy, but maybe not.
Yeah, but it's like it, you remember Ace Combat 7 where it was like all this stuff was going on with these people who weren't the player.
Yeah.
The player, because your job is just to, you know, fly around and shoot things. And you have to be a silent, faceless protagonist.
The enemy-held Wrigley Air Base is located in close proximity to our front lines, making it the proverbial knife at our throat. A large Erujian bomber contingent was deployed to Wrigley. Their intentions are clear. A full-scale strike on our forces at North Point is imminent. Your mission is to catch these bombers on the ground and destroy them. We intend to turn the parking ramp at Wrigley into a junkyard.
On the ground. Okay.
How many video games have there been with the word combat? You had Mortal Kombat.
There was combat for the Atari.
Right.
Yeah.
The tank game.
Two? What about the combat tribes? That's technically all one word.
Countless Ace Combat games.
Combat tribe? Okay.
I could get the F5E, but I don't have enough money. I'm probably blowing through these missions too much to.
You know, the first time it showed the missile, by the way, I thought that was like another plane for a second, so I was like, oh, that's adorable. A little plane, huh?
Flying around.
I'll bet Keith's in Yellow 13.
But he's from the future.
Oh, that's true. I forgot. Keith is Eternal.
Like a future boy.
Keith is like a baby right now.
Watch me earn my Ace Wings today.
I think
doesn't mean
he's got.
Sorry.
Keep your guard up.
I think he got like. I think three got.
Can you play his baby
game?
Yeah, I took a glance at the wiki when I was looking up stuff. When we were trying to look up something else with, like how we can avoid evade missiles, and it said something about it being like a computer simulation, like it was all just like the whole thing was just a, you know, virtuosity existence kind of thing.
So.
Engage.
combat chest.
Get that guy. Now you can see, since it's PS2, then now they can make different grass and stuff down there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's not just polygons. Well, I mean, it's just polygons, but it looks like things now.
Yeah, it looks like stuff.
Yeah.
And Ace Combat 1 looked rough. Like, it was a very early PS1 game. Mm-hmm.
And we got gradients. Fuck off. Combat 1.
No, that's a different game.
The air. The byline for it was air combat, slightly better than Pilot Wings.
Yeah. Not as good as Pilot Wings 64.
Any of you guys listen to the 99% Invisible podcast?
I can't hear it. It's invisible.
Just because this there's a new episode about the largest ball of twine.
Ooh! Are we in it? We should have guest starred on that.
No, I think it's...
Hey, that's all. What's...
Like the
researcher
who's trying to get the bottom
of the actual large ball of twine. Well, so that, like, literally. Like, the one that we saw was not the largest ball of twine.
Yeah, it was made by the largest made by one person.
It was the largest continuous ball of twine made by one person.
So many qualifiers. Immediately.
And to be fair, Weird Al never claimed it was the biggest ball of twine. It was the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota.
Minnesota. I still like that video we took where everyone's just like, yeah, it did it, yeah!
Bombs.
What a dumb idea.
I especially like that because there was a moment where me and Jimmy turned to each other and they did it like it was the winning. Like it was, we were both on the, like, cheering for the same team and then just won. It was really great.
I think someone also in the background says, two in a row! Because he's starting to
Oh, I totally
right.
That's great.
Okay. Five taken off.
I know. Okay, I don't know. Play it upside down.
Yep.
And,
Box two. Squint, are you missing out on the Ace Combat 7 experience? I can help. Missile. Stall. Hold up.
It's not saying missile this time. Oh shit! Get him! Yeah! Destroyed!
Ace Combat 7th guest.
That's a
good mashup.
Yeah. Genres. Totally
I'm in a haunted plane.
Oh, that would be good though.
Just one room. It's the cockpit.
Solving the puzzles like the puzzles like the actual cockpit that you have to figure out how to land the plane.
You have to learn how to fly a plane. Yeah.
You gotta push a bunch of sliding piece puzzle games around with your plane.
The attack was a success.
Oh yeah, S rank this bad boy.
Were eliminated, and a full scale airstrike on North Point was averted.
I'm sure it'll all go exactly like this for the rest of the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not like these missions are like very easy and meant to get you into the groove of the game. Ooh, a 30,000 rank bonus though, that's nice.
I can buy big airplane.
One night, a spirited group made their way up the door, chased out the sullen army grunts, and commandeered the place. Even I knew who they were. The patch on their sleeve was the mark of the proud Air Force. A loud-mouthed, middle-aged man went around, announcing each pilot's results for the day and his running kill record. For those who exceeded 5 kills, a thorough toasting and soaking followed. I believe it was their custom to call
toasting
a pilot
and
an ace
soaking.
Once he shot down 5 planes.
I'm toasting.
After completing the day's review, the same guy, the squadron adjutant, went on to announce, "And now, for our leader's results." Everyone turned around to look at the quiet man who sat alone, strumming a guitar. I found myself drawn to the music from his guitar. Our Yellow 13 bagged 3 more today, bringing his new tally up to 64 kills.
I ran up and shanked him.
With a tentative smile, The man with the guitar turned to me and asked me to accompany him on my harmonica. I brought it up to my lips and I started a new song. I had finally found him. But by some fluke, it was my father's favorite song. The one he used to play at the end of each day.
Shanked him after the song.
Ringing Bell 2, airplanes.
This is where we get the Ace Combat era where everyone talks like a poem, like a weird flowery.
The glimmer in his eyes caused me to stay my hand.
The Allied forces are retreating, and survivors are gathering at the northern port of St. Ark. However, the radar facilities atop Mount Chesnut provide tactical support.
It says raider base.
As a result, our evac mission is in jeopardy. If our troops can successfully evacuate and regroup at North Point, they will become a formidable force in future battles. Your mission is to destroy the radar facilities on Mount Chesnut, thereby blinding the enemy and hiding our troop movements.
Okay. Looks like more air to ground. What's the other weapon for? Spread bomb. I've got it for you, hold on. Contains an incendiary jelly, which turns into liquid fire on impact. I think I'll buy,
jelly.
I think I'll buy the F5.
Disagreeable peanut butter incendiary jelly. My favorite. Yeah.
Weapon. What does F5 have?
This reminds me how in that one episode you were just so mad at incendiary ammo. Anyways.
Incendiary ammo.
Or should I take a rocket saw?
So whenever, as opposed to the previous Ace Combats up until this point, do you have like a whole lot of options of stuff you can buy in this one?
Each of those boxes in the middle is an aircraft. So, how many other 20-some aircraft?
That's pretty good.
This combat area.
You guys tricked me. Prime Day still going on.
Never said that the Prime Day wasn't still going on. I'm just saying that it's 6 hours. As well.
This is Chesna Radar 1. Bandits approaching Vector 135.
I got some hits on that.
So. 100% agree with the boycott and not buying things, but.
Pre-streaming on Twitch.
Right. To the viewers consist of people that are banded and troubled. So.
Yeah. Yavuz is here, just being quiet.
Just calling you.
Calling you out, Yavuz.
What about PewDiePie? Like,
Bots too.
Bandits and offering sponsored content.
That's a kill.
Selling.
We're doing this shit for us. We're just friends hanging out, buddy.
Uh-huh.
And Yavuz. Hey, Yavuz.
Hello. Having a good time with friends playing video games.
Hey, let's welcome Yavuz.
Not getting mad at video games.
Welcome, Yavuz.
Not getting mad. Yes, hello.
Hello, Yavuz. What can you do?
This music very much matches up with Ace Combat. I'm glad this is happening.
The stirring love theme.
Love theme for Ace Combat. And bomb away.
I wish I had a slide whistle. It's like a old historic theater that has a pipe organ built into it.
Ooh.
It's like only like five of them. Or something. Every, like once a month, we'll do a Sunday night day. We go down and watch a silent movie with the pipe organ accompanying it.
Wow, yeah.
It's pretty great.
Oh, pineapple.
Spray's bomb is a great.
Mobius 1 is on the target.
Yeah. Can you do Axel M?
Okay.
Close up.
Perfect.
Pickle.
So the answer is no.
Hey, fake it till you
make it. With 2 minutes of fiddling, I could do it.
Kid, you're fired. You said you were the best accompanying man to set behind a set of 88 keys. Listen, kid, I'm going to give you one more chance to write the score for my new video game. You stop that boy.
Okay, well, this this sound effect is called group hug, so go well.
Got spooky ghosts haunting the game.
Missile hit.
Okay.
Bandits in gun range.
Yeah, he got him.
Say my first Ace Combat rodeo. Although I instinctively want to do the super sharp accelerate at the same time as you break turns from Ace Combat 7. This is like muscle memory for me. Okay, let's get some bombs here.
What was the name of the Japanese video game that had a soundtrack that...
Bombs away.
I think it was a survival horror game that was just incredibly bad. Like, it was made by somebody who did not know how to compose music.
Target is neutralized.
Or it was made in such a hurry that it was legendarily bad.
I think that was one of the Resident Evil, like, early remakes. I think it was, like, the redo of Resident Evil for PlayStation. And that was notable because the composer was deaf.
What was going on with Resident Evil 1 anyway is the soundtrack thing was a scam.
Yeah.
Okay.
The guy pretended. The soundtrack isn't bad, but what happened was there was this weird like Cyrano shit going on.
That's right. I read that story.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Yeah. The composer to Resident Evil 1 isn't really the composer to Resident Evil 1. This was like a years long scam where one of them was actually writing the music and someone else was taking credit for it.
Yeah.
And
it was like a music teacher or something like that.
Yeah.
The student was the one who was actually. Talented composer.
Yeah, and it wasn't until the Olympics one year,
yeah,
when the guy blew his cover because they were like, because they were asked to, he was asked to write a song for like the Japanese like figure skaters or whatever, and the guy said, I can't do this any longer. I can't implicate this poor figure skater into our scam.
I'm living
and blew
alive.
The lid off. That is a fucking true story.
Stranger than fiction.
Yeah. So.
Approaching return.
Resident Evil soundtrack trivia for your Ace Combat story.
Thank you.
It's true.
S ranking on this bad boy.
Mobius 1, perform landing check. You are clear.
How about
to
the
land.
Story of the Canadian man who killed a deer?
2 miles to touchdown.
So he took the deer's teeth and made dentures, and then ate the deer.
Gravity Falls?
Did he apologize to the deer first?
Check it out.
It's a true story.
One mile to touchdown.
Hey, you need teeth, you know? Deer doesn't need them anymore.
You're on the money.
Francis Wharton.
Yeah, it was actually the same guy as D.B. Cooper.
What?
D.B. Cooper is also the guy who stole a deer's teeth.
He's also the guy who composed the soundtrack to Resident Evil.
Yeah, all of those people are D.B. Cooper.
Francis Wharton wasn't D.B. Cooper, he was a real guy.
That's why they never found him, because they thought he would...
They were looking for a man with human teeth.
None of these drawings look like
that. Nicely done, Mobius One. Go and prepare for your next sortie.
Very deceptive pair of sunglasses.
Commission, the enemy's command and control is degraded. The evac and regrouping efforts are proceeding as scheduled.
I love watching these swooping arrows.
Yeah.
They make
me look super competent.
I guess that's the thing. You're in a jet. It's not like you're going to make any erratic, like you bump into something and have to stop. Move around the obstacle.
This line draft doesn't play by the rules.
I do like that one head-on kill that I got. That was very cool.
Yeah. Boom.
Hello, XJO96. Thanks for tuning in.
My favorite XJO.
We've discovered the Erusians are transporting a large quantity of strategic supplies and...
What are you playing this on? This XJO?
Oh, I am playing it on PCSX2.
The Aker fleet stationed here.
I do actually own this game. I ripped it myself.
Archival backup.
You're allowed to have one.
Yeah.
I'm going to delete it after 24 hours, don't worry.
Yeah, archival backup copies of all of the awesome power moves on CD-ROM that they're broken up because you have to put the second disk in. The AVI file was too big for CDR.
So PCSX2 is a really good emulator. It currently has marks 95.75% of the games attempted on it as playable.
What's it? What does it rank on the Bristol scale?
Well, one of the games that is not playable on it is the secret best Tony Hawk's Pro Skater spin-off game, Wakeboarding Unleashed.
Ooh, an F-16.
It's a real good game, and I'd love to stream it because I think it's I love it.
Let's see what sub-weapons for the F-16 I can get.
It's clearly unplayable on everything. Everything.
What sub-weapons are you looking at?
It breaks everything you put in. Surface
missile.
Yeah, no.
People hitting.
It's too beautiful for this world.
It looks like it'd be
wasteful, unleashed.
I want more aircraft, so I'm going to save up.
It red-ringed my Atari Jaguar.
I think unboxing the Atari Jaguar red-rings the Atari Jaguar. Ixtro says, I remember playing wakeboarding at my friend's house. One of the objectives was to smash fat people out of their inner tubes.
Yep. That's correct.
All right, XJO, your story checks out. We've cross-referenced it with our resident wakeboarding expert, Boots Ranger.
Yeah, to the tune of "I Want to Be Your Dog" by the Stooges. It's great.
Oh, that's a bomb! I thought that was one of the planes you could fly. I'm like, no. It doesn't have any wings.
That's what I said. That's exactly what I said. Like,
already into the experimental aircraft. Yes.
Mobius One, Sky Eye here. You should be getting visual on the transport soon. Destroy the E-767s hidden nearby to clear the jamming.
Radar jamming planes.
Good luck.
Oh no.
Uh-oh. Mobius One, engage.
You see those green ripples? That's jamming my radar, so I can't quite tell what's there. I only get glimpses.
That's anti-radar juice.
They make it really hard for you to watch the TV show MASH.
Yeah.
Yes. No radar. Seems like the Garfield without Garfield.
Oh, brother.
All these opening sequences are just like, just spending way too long just showing what's happening in the camp. No voices or anybody talking to each other.
I see him.
Poor Impossible Watchers. When it's 30. Like, Ash was a show about the Korean conflict. In which the doctors and nurses.
Gary Burton played the character Radar O'Reilly.
Yeah, it was the TV show was a spinoff of the Robert Altman movie.
And Gary Burton was the only actor to appear in both films.
Bandit closing at 6.
That's correct.
And he gave Big Bird his teddy bear, which is also named Radar. Yeah.
And he was in and he was the dad in Better Off Dead.
What?
One of my favorite movies.
Really?
Box 2.
I don't remember, but I mean, your wakeboarding story checked out, so...
I want Boots to be my shitty IMDb.
Yeah, I was going to say this. Tonight's conversation brought to you by IMDb.
Target hit.
No way. Not Gary Burgoff.
You're thinking of Winchester.
I was thinking of Winchester. I thought, was it Winchester in the movie as well? No.
I think, no, because he was... He came up later. He was replaced Frank. Jammer.
That's right.
But he also plays a Martian. Justice League TV pilot from the 90s.
What?
Yeah, look it up. It's like a fat, paunchy Martian Manhunter.
Yeah.
Locked on. Box 2.
I got greedy. This is really good. The soundtrack really starts to.
Nice kill.
Yeah, it's good. It's good stuff.
Got his tail.
Mirage 2000. Yeah. It's a French made fighter jet. They look very cool. Delta Wing.
Now we need to talk about Trapper John MD, right?
No, we don't. No, we talk about that or Aftermath. Or
Aftermath. Walter. It was WALTER. It's a TV pilot for a radar show.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I've got him.
Jackson was apparently in it.
So you just got to eyeball this the whole time the radar's jammed, aren't you?
Yeah, I don't want to end the mission prematurely, though, because I need points for higher ranks. So I have to actually leave mission targets alive. I'll go after the camera first.
Okay, get that guy. Get him.
Radar lock. Mobius 1, box 2.
Ooh. So I got two targets I can exploit. I'll get rid of one. The other one.
Should be clear and functioning now.
I like the chatter by the enemy. That's when guy's like, oh my god, everyone I know from my training looks dead. He goes, don't be a wimp. There's not that many of them.
It's her. Negative.
Well, apparently there was a PC enemy version of Wake Bloody Unleashed.
Fox 2.
Well done.
Target hit.
Are you about to unleash some Wake Force?
About to unleash a lot of malware.
Bombs, buddy.
Could be though.
Where'd this little purple gorilla pal come
from? Bonsai buddy.
Well, yeah, Bonsai buddy is so good though. The best malware ever.
What was the gator? The alligator?
I don't remember. I just remember the parrot and Bonsai. Parrot was Petey.
What about the Santa Claus that walked across the bottom of your the top of your taskbar?
We've got ourselves a real attack here.
6 minutes, plenty of time.
Thanks for the save. Get him. Get him. Where is he?
Coming up behind him.
Is it correct that the title of the game is actually Big Farting Unleashed, featuring Sean Murray?
Sean Murray got second billing after the wakeboarding concert.
Every single other Activision, like, extreme sports game was called, like, so-and-so's sport.
Even paintball.
Sean Murray gets, like, second billing.
There was a paintball game, and it had, and it's, like, featuring some guy who I guess is really good at paintball. Box two, box two.
What was the skateboarding game that was, that featured the guy who was a famous snowboarder?
Well, I mean, there was Sean White pro
Sean
snowboarding.
White?
Yeah, it was Sean White. And, yeah, and, like, that game was sponsored by Stride Gum.
Mm-hmm.
And so there was, like, this whole thing about it where you have to, like, there's a bunch of, you're in an area and there's a bunch of posters all over it, and they say, no skateboarding and no chewing, and you've got to grind over those posters, and it turns them into Stride ads.
Yep.
Because you got to take down the man by putting Stride gum ads all over the place. It's no
good. I remember Giant Bomb did a quick one showing that, and Jeff from Giant Bomb was very vocal about how much he hated that. It was pretty great. Yeah. We got it.
Nobody left.
That's all you do. Radar
lock. Don't let your flying get sloppy. Are you letting your flying get sloppy? Sloppy flying.
Don't do sloppy flying. Oh, you got him.
Good job. Get nailed here.
Good job. You shot down the enemy transport without any radar. Bumping too, or was?
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Victory spins, victory rotations.
Mm-hmm. You know, above the mission accomplished thing, I know it says, like, SYS, but it's kind of, since it's kind of blurred out, it looks like it says bye.
Bye.
The mission was a success. The Zerujian air corridor has been effectively shut down.
Zerujian.
Mm-hmm.
That is one thing I really love about Strange Real, is, like, the fake names for stuff is, like, it's very close to what actual people would say, but it's just off enough where it's just like, that sounds weird to say. Like, yeah.
Yep.
Congress Harbor, home of the Aegir fleet, is completely dependent on a single petrochemical complex for its fuel supply. The complex consists of a land-based oil refinery storage facility and an offshore oil drilling platform. Your mission is to go out and destroy, or at least damage, these sites.
Yeah.
Our objective is to reduce production output of this complex to 20% or less. By cutting off the port's fuel supply, we will delay and disrupt the combat deployment of the Aegir fleet.
So, air to ground, right? But there are lots of targets of opportunity in this mission, looks like, so let's see if I can afford something. Oh, no new aircraft.
Aww.
Advanced air-to-ground missile, that looks like a good buy.
It's definitely a buy.
Mm-hmm.
Missile reviews. Missile reviews.
Yeah, this one's a buy.
It's a buy.
I'm gonna take it for a spin right now.
Missile reviewer.
Okay, score at least 2,000 points within the time limit and continue to destroy enemy forces. So, pretty much for 10 minutes, I gotta go hog wild.
Do it, go ham. It's for ham. Alright, tanker.
I'm just having fun thinking of poetic ways of transpiring. Make their oil the kindling of the fire of your spirit.
Yeah. Clear to engage. Bandit confirmed.
confirmed at Vector 050.
So none of these are strictly like, mission engage. Critical targets. I should probably prioritize the oil rig though. That guy chickened out, he turned around. He's like, oh wait, that's a protagonist. Oh, shit, I'm out of here.
Gone.
I didn't sign on to fight protagonists.
Splash one.
Oil rigs. This is what I'm talking about. This is why I brought these missiles.
Ooh, let's see how these work.
Oh, they even do the thing where they come down from the top.
That's cool.
Yeah, AGM 45s do that because they're tank buster missiles. And the weakest,
so like,
weakest part of tanks' armor is at the top.
Yeah, I was about to ask. Cool.
Enemy facility destroyed.
On that, Sam.
Get rid of that chopper, dude. Fox 2.
Not a special.
AA guns destroyed. Enemy facility destroyed.
Do they have a rearm? Oh, they do have a rearm. So you gotta balance going to rearm with how much time you have left, though. That's the thing.
Oh, I see.
Because you have to get as many points as you can within a certain time limit.
Enemy facility destroyed. Fox 2.
Doing pretty good with just straight missiles here. Oh, my wingmen are taking points from me. Actually, I don't know if the stuff... I don't know if the stuff they blow up counts for me or not.
Maybe it's just for effect. Maybe they're not actually strength targets.
No, I saw one. Like, a missile I didn't fire slammed into the target.
Oh, okay. I just saw the explosion. I didn't think the target flew up. I see.
Aircraft are probably worth more points.
I don't miss.
This guy's maneuvering pretty well. Yeah, 60 points is pretty much the same as ground targets.
We're taking heat from below. Hard left. Hard enemy radar spike. What about the other target? Let's flank him. Enemy facility destroyed. Mobius 1, Box 2. Evade Mobius 1! Just don't get shot down.
I like how in this game you can dodge missiles. That's pretty awesome. It's an improvement.
Got some new people there.
Enemy facility destroyed. Missile hit.
Okay, well, I passed the mission.
Fox 2.
I just gotta work on improving the rating.
Facility destroyed.
Winchester. That
Winchester means you're out of ammo.
Oh, it is. Oh,
okay. Target hit. Don't fly.
Bingo means you're running low on fuel.
Radar lock.
Although there's infinite fuel in this game, so that's thankfully never an issue. Cannons in the area. Wow, it's pretty stiff requirements to get into the B rating even. Oh, I've only got 6 missiles left. I should probably go. And everybody's so quiet now.
Because I'm invested. Are you going to get it? Got that Ace Combat music.
Oh, I am it. I'm in it too. So, that's good.
Missile,
and it takes a long time to return to base. It's so dark, the visibility's poor. Oh, okay.
Perform landing check. You are cleared to
land. It's so dark, it's hard to see out here, but why?
Mobius 1, you are cleared
to
take...
Oh, that's slick. The, apparently, if you, like, play the landing section, the timer still keeps running down. So...
Sorry, you didn't land enough.
So, I'm just gonna skip that. Hitting that big cluster of targets over to the northwest.
310, 12 miles.
10, 12 miles. Yep, on my way there.
Refinery, red vector 310, 8 miles.
Nope. I gotta get these special weapons off. That target was in diamond. Why would you?
Just cause.
Thank you. I set some up, you knocked some down. Okay, I'm at A rank.
Jimmy muted himself. I think Boots, I guess, disappeared.
Enemy facility destroyed.
To avoid.
I'm giving myself a haircut.
What? Okay, both of you have bizarre answers.
I just set time here.
Yeah, but, like, you've been here the whole time. Like, aren't you impressed with how exploding this game is?
It's very exploding.
Same. Meanwhile, Jimmy's beating a cat and giving himself a haircut at the same time.
It's like scary Christmas gumdrops is on course 4 of time, so. It's a whole tasting.
It's Jimmy's new public access show. Let's paint, feed our cat, and get on a treadmill.
Oh, what is
Hard enemy radar spike.
What happened
to that
guy?
Another head-on kill.
One of his paintings.
Jimmy Franks?
No, the Let's Paint TV guy.
Bob Ross?
Nope.
No. There's a guy who would do like
John Kilda.
John Kilda what?
John Kilda.
Radio failure. Facility neutralized. Mission complete.
It's been 5 years since his last episode on YouTube.
Oh no.
What's happened to John Kilduff?
Dove killed him back.
Yesterday he was live tweeting Stranger Things. Said don't eat apple fritters, so spoiler.
Alright.
Oh, he's still painting. You can see some of his paintings on, oh, this is really good. On his Twitter account, there's a bunch of, bunch of little poops having a band in a flaming dumpster.
Let's get them for garbage day.
That's really cute. That's really good. I like it.
Oh, so are they, is the yellow aircraft here, are they like the badasses? Like
yeah, I'm guessing these guys are not beatable. I already have an S-Rank out here.
I don't think that's how that works anymore.
Yeah, it is actually. It's a dirty secret that I really shouldn't have told you.
I leveled up enough. I'm out.
What the heck does he do that?
Not quite enough.
They had to up the poetry in some of the games.
Yeah.
Alright, Skip Rogers, gotta land this. Spin.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna cross the border. Invert.
Can you land the plane upside down?
Once.
Can you have your guy fall out of the cockpit? My ego's like, too much.
What? No, I was wrong. He still updates his channel very regularly. He's still doing this shit. It's amazing.
Picture is clear. Bandits are down or no factor. All aircraft RTB.
Bandits aren't down. We ran like bitches.
The enemy lost 5 million barrels of reserves and the ability
let's,
to process.
Let's paint and dribble TV.
Barrels of crude
paint and dribble TV.
The Aider fleet is effectively immobilized and
he's trying
no
to paint while dribbling the basketball the whole time.
Unfortunately,
it's really good.
Our losses were high as well. We now rely on more skills.
This
rubber
was like painting and on a treadmill and doing something else, and there was just. It was just people like calling. He took callers and they just like paraded him the whole time.
Oh, yeah. The callers would just yell endless profanity at him and he'd try to maintain a positive attitude while painting, running on a treadmill, and making smoothies or like frying steak or whatever. He also, for a while, he was painting while riding his bike through Los Angeles.
They were the elite flight squadron, chosen to protect the cannon. Ironically, the same cannon that was created to shoot down the asteroids became a catalyst to the war.
Oh yeah, the asteroids!
No came, the that's like a major thing in this story.
Yes. Forgot entirely about this.
So this is the game that introduced the Stonehenge.
I thought of the words
weapon,
I would
right?
use to confront him.
You
time.
See Stonehenge in I think Zero, which is like the prequel to all of this.
Although I harbored okay. these feelings,
it was also the
me.
Last game to be released on PS2. So.
I could never get close to him. His wingman was always by his side. Despite having a gentle demeanor. I could tell that the wingmen would never allow danger to get near Yellow 13, even on land. The pillar of their group, 13 exuded an air of invincibility. He always chose to fly a five-plane formation. He was a man who prided himself not on his kill record, but on his record of never losing a squadron member. It's difficult for me to describe just how good Yellow 13's flying was, but I witnessed it once from the ground. The lead plane of the five-plane formation should have turned the same arc with the same timing as the others. Yet only his plane drew sharp contrails. His heartfelt compassion towards the weaker enemies he downed. Someday, if an equal appeared and challenged the limits of his skills in a fight, he would bear no resentment about being shot down. He said this himself. And so as time passed, I found the goodness of a home in their company. Leaving them was no longer an option for me now.
Yeah, the Stonehenge, I believe, was able to keep the, was able to break up the asteroid enough that it didn't just wipe out all life, but the fragments of the asteroid still hit the planet and caused a lot of damage.
We will launch a surprise attack on the Aether fleet while it lies immobilized at Comberth Harbor. This large-scale airstrike will be the largest and the most strategic operation since the transfer of HQ to North Korea.
I am glad that Yellow 13 is extremely anime. No one's enough of a challenge for me, but if I find someone who is a challenge, I will not mind at all if he kills my ass.
I will acknowledge them as a rival. Of course, I'll be dead, but...
He'll be acknowledging as his plane is flaming to the ground.
Okay, so whatever, now we can purchase an A-10 and a Mirage 2000.
Ooh, that's got, that's one of the planes with a face on it. I like it.
3 and 10.
But yeah, I do appreciate how anime Yellow 13 is. Every time I saw him, I would be struck with how shonen as hell he was. He was always talking about being the best fighter jet pilot.
Plane is powered by friendship.
He would never shut up about his nakama.
I don't like both of these, but I want to see what sub-weapons they have.
Like what Ixjo said in the chat. It's like, I swear, if he smirks and goes, heh, a worthy opponent, finally, in an angsty way.
Oh, that'd be so good, though!
Yeah, you got it, Ixjo. You're finishing my thought. I like it.
I'm gonna get the multi-roll. Better. I'm gonna see what the weapons are.
What's your favorite anime, Isfahan?
My favorite anime?
Yeah, or your favorite anime, Isfahan. Either way.
Long-range air-to-surface missile. Ooh. What's the other one? My favorite anime is probably Kaiji. It's like really good.
I've not yet watched that. I'm meaning to.
No, that's the gambling one, right?
Yeah, it's really
with
fun.
The dark outlines and stuff.
Yeah.
That's a pretty good choice.
Long range. Surface missile. Yeah, I'll buy it. Why not?
That's a good thing, a video game to make you say. Long range missile. Yeah, I'll buy it.
What's your favorite anime, Portex?
My favorite anime?
Yeah.
I do like One Punch Man.
One Punch Man is very good.
Starring Juan Punch Man.
Juan Punch Man, attorney at law.
Juan Punch Man.
I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if Juan made that a character. I mean, you know.
Invincible fleet. Score at least 3,000 points within the time limit and continue to destroy enemy forces.
Initiate attack. I'm learning our skills. Aircraft clear to engage any and all targets. Sink the invincible. That's extremely weird. Which I enjoyed.
Lots of, Okay, so you notice how, like, the blips on the radar are different colors? Like, some are dark orange and others.
Oh, yeah?
The darker orange blips are worth more points, so helps you prioritize.
So hopefully you're not colorblind. Go pick those out.
Enemy destroyer sunk. Fox 2.
Extremely good.
That's really good, Extra. Aegis class Raven sunk. You know what? I like the cut of your dick, Extra. Carrier Geophon sunk.
Repairing, engage. Somebody asked me what my favorite anime was.
Yeah, Boots, what's your favorite anime?
Hey, Boots Rain Gear. What is your favorite anime?
Yeah, I don't know.
Doctato.
Doctato is also good.
Is that the one?
It's like a 3-minute show for kids.
Yeah.
With a bunch of animals that are also vegetables. Enemy destroyer sunk.
See, strong premise. AA
guns destroyed. Yeah, and the localization was really fun because they're all They're all pun names in Japan, but they're all pretty successful pun names in England. In English too.
Very good. Battleship
Tanager sunk. Oh my god, Doug Taylor. Box 2. Sam
destroyed. Missile warning. It was Doug Taylor's girlfriend was Hedge Tato. Oh, me? Well, my favorite anime is Bleach. I love Bleach.
Jimmy brings super into Bleach.
I like to sit around with Gary and just watch hundreds of episodes of Bleach. Especially the filler.
And then we talk about the
doing a great impression of somebody who, like, hasn't looked at anime in 10 years. Hey, Grandpa, what's your favorite anime? Oh, I've heard of Bleach.
I'm sorry, I can't just play this, but Jimmy Franks, doing a Jimmy Franks voice and going, especially the filler, just really tickled me. Oh, spoons have a shot. Like, hey, have you caught up to the latest episode of Naruto? No, I just watched the filler and nothing else.
Just the filler. What a great cut that would be.
I only like the part of the anime that really doesn't progress the story.
Can we do that though? Can we have like Dragon Ball Aiik and just have just the filler? We never get to Namek. Namek never happens.
Oh my god. That would actually be, I think, a legit fun like podcast or show idea where it's just the filler, where it's like you only watch the filler of like famous anime. Bandit closing at 6. Like reviewed it.
Except that I was doing it Obama. It's like I might as well have been. I don't.
Well, I do like Leap.
Leap Obama would be such a good kid.
Obama is definitely more than Naruto.
Well, I would have to say that my favorite One Piece. Animation quality gets a bit bad later. Season,
Mr. President,
I still really enjoy it.
Mr. President, which member of the Straw Hat Pirates is your favorite?
That would be Zoro. He's excellent swordsman.
I like how all of you have different views on which member of the Straw Hats Obama likes the best.
I mean, Zoro would actually be pretty good because he did say Omar was his favorite character ever. Omar from the Wire, so you know, not too good. I see you all as my Nakama, and I will defend you with my life.
Grant has a good
idea. Yeah, but he does.
Never forget the that Lord of the Rings self-insert that we read.
Yeah.
And he made Legolas. I think it was Legolas he made him Obama.
Yeah, I remember that because that was classic internet weird, and Bunny Bird was like, I have no idea what any of this stuff means. Just find something for me. We can do. Fox 2. I think it was Zarla that found like a list by Laura. It's like, what about this? Enemy destroyer sunk.
Sounds like a Zarla find.
Yeah. Man, she showed me some legendary post. So none of this is gonna really make any sense if you don't know anything about Harry Potter.
Okay.
But. Well, I'm gonna put this in the chat.
Let me do my lemon impression. All right.
But the stuff that is highlighted in this screenshot is still extremely good. Or like regardless of your Harry Potter knowledge, but because the idea is in Harry Potter you get sorted into whatever house you're in, or whatever. And nerds really do not take well to the concept of in this canon, you get a thing, but you don't get to pick what it is. That always just throws nerds completely off. Because they don't get to pick their favorite from what if they were the thing.
Completely in control of their own environment.
So, this is some some sort of live journal Harry Potter community of some sort, where I guess part of the shtick is they have to sort you into whatever house they feel that you would belong in. I think, as they can see here, But this guy is like really trying to convince people that he would be in the same house as Harry Potter because that's the one where you're brave and that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So he comes up with a lot of like tough guy shit to prove how brave he is, which is really good.
Yeah, like, oh, you know, Harry Potter, there's four houses. There's protagonists, there's nerds, there's nobody cares, and there's evil people.
And there's evil people. It's like, or do you mean more conventional bravery? How about standing up to a man twice my size and refusing to back down until the girl he was trying to leave with against her will got away, after he had opened my chest bone with a claymore?
Like the Andy Personnel mine?
Yes.
Sorting Hat yelling out that he's a troper. Missed.
How about darting into traffic on Interstate 95 to grab a toddler who had wiggled out of her car seat during a sorting out of a fender bender? None of this shit happened, dude. You're a liar.
You just ruined me. You just ruined the filming of Baby's Day Out 2.
Baby's Day Out 2.
It was gonna be a classic.
Yeah. Yeah, because the first one.
Yeah.
Baby's Day Out 2. Babies in the City.
I'm actually extremely damaged.
Yeah, you're blinking. You're like arcade boss about to die blinking now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you are. You're blinking in the corner. But you do have 309 guns strapped to your...
If you were Bebop or Rocksteady, you would be like one hit away from
mm-hmm. But I'd have that bullshit move I could just keep doing over and over again. That would eat all your quarters.
You guys need to watch the Turtles in Time speedrun. Mr. VQ. It gets around like, that stuff very weird.
That's one of the only ones I watched.
Yeah.
Good strat. I have not watched that one yet. I should watch it.
I watched that one and the blindfolded punch at one.
Yeah,
on Squint's recommendation on Twitter.
Yeah. Extremely good.
I pretty much tell everybody I meet to go watch that.
Yeah.
Like, you know, people in line, coffee shop.
People on the bus.
People on the bus with headphones on.
As soon as the bus starts moving, you run up and stand at the front and start yelling.
Let me tell you about Salad!
The only time it went south is the one time I went into a bank and I yelled out, "All right, this will only take a second." I stole that joke from Tommy Boy.
Tommy Boy, one of the greatest movies.
I have not seen it yet. I should.
Should.
I know.
Yeah, see, that was my reaction.
Break
missile. But you don't like fireworks?
No, I don't remember it.
Yeah, that's fair. I mean, the plot isn't exactly like. Unique.
Guys, I'd appreciate it if you'd stop spoiling Tommy Boy for people who haven't seen it.
Oh, you tried to spoil Resident Evil 2 earlier.
Yeah. Well, we're just talking about
it.
Hey, we're just talking about what's on the cover.
I figured it was fair game by now.
Well, Toast is a wussy and hasn't played a lot of horror games.
When did Tommy Boy come out?
95? It's older than Resident Evil 2, okay?
But I do have a copy of it, and I am going to let him borrow it, so...
Good.
Well, I mean, if we're talking about playing the original, I've got it on my Vita, so I guess I could just play it.
Good. Watching you play horror games is really good. It's a good thing. I still have that video of you playing PT. It's extremely good.
Oh, yeah, that was good. I'm not a wuss at all.
If I had waited one more second, you would have been a toast sandwich.
Toasted sandwich.
Sounds delicious.
Oh man, I actually used that line for when I was in animation school. We had to do an animated face to like a 3D face to dialogue, and I did that. That was too close. You're almost a chill sandwich, and I guess that probably was a poor choice because. Most of my teachers were, like, English was not their first language. They spoke it just fine, but I think the term Jill Sandwich really threw them off.
Oh, are we allowed to remark on this?
Enemy facility destroyed. Sexing?
It can't be. Hard enemy radar
spike. Alright, guys, I have to go host an office-themed trivia night.
Okay.
Ah,
great. Godspeed, sir.
Yeah. Oh, the best.
Check six.
I've no doubt, like, I've seen making a joke. I don't know anything about it. Enemy stolen
shit. Oh, like,
off the internet.
Oh, so it's like off of the office, not like the concept of being in an office.
Right, yeah. Proper water cooler etiquette.
That would be so good, though.
How to file an OSHA claim.
it's like, alright, the theme of this, the theme of these questions are, people who keep stealing my lunch.
Right. Where is the first aid kit?
Filling out a timesheet. You'll have 20 seconds to answer.
You grab a chair, like sit in it backwards and say, all right, we're going to talk about ethics. Godspeed.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to do fill the place that the owner was pretty insistent on doing a second night. So if anybody who has any office trivia questions, they can send my way.
Let them escape from the harvest. Why will it not? There we go.
All right, later, dudes.
Airplanes. Franks for Jimmy.
Frank God for Jimmy.
Frank God. He's a Jimmy boy.
Negative. Okay, so to get these submarines, I have to fire missiles at a very, very specific angle. Right up into the bays where they are. Let's go. 2 minutes to get to the S rank.
Fox 2. Enemy facility destroyed.
Pick up
the small fry. Concentrate on the larger ships. Bandit closing at 6. Missed. Hard right now. Enemy destroyer sunk. Mobius 1 hit. Enemy submarine sunk.
Nice. Probably have to get to 5,000.
Sam's on that carrier.
Damage, so I think we're gonna play defensive.
Get him.
Still okay.
Negative.
Make him think he'll get God.
Yeah, go in after the submarine's the right call because they're worth 120 points.
Bandit
confirmed at vector 250.
Just fly inside the sub pen. Oh, sure, X-Joe. Flying out of the sub pen, not so much.
Enemy fleet and harbor facilities confirmed destroyed.
What is my favorite anime? Do we mean like series or movie? Or does
mission
it matter?
Complete. I don't know. Aircraft, RTB.
Whatever.
Like a, erotic or non-erotic?
How many cat girls are we allowed to talk?
How sensual is it?
But if we're gonna talk about hentai, we're gonna be here all night. No. What song is this?
Might be somebody's national anthem.
The Erujian's so-called invincible fleet has been destroyed. Their plans for invading North Point have been delayed indefinitely. Although we are still far from triumphant, this victory gave our troops a much-needed boost in morale.
Good.
Oh.
If it's series, I think I'd have to go with right now My Hero Academia. Really good stuff. My favorite anime movie is End of Evangelion, just because it's a complete mind. It's just insanity all the way through, and I love it. So.
Your next mission is to attack the solar power generator.
End of Evangelion is really good if you're into Tang.
These generators equal nuclear ones in output and provide about 60% of energy for the illusion's military industrial complex.
I don't get the connections.
Everybody turns into Tang.
Since they require oil for remaining supplies, we cannot stop power production by interdicting their supply lines.
Oh, we're going to do something evil. We're going to blow up a solar power plant.
Oh no!
But also divert attention from our own imminent invasion.
All that solar radiation is going to leak into the countryside. Be Chernobyl, too. Stranger,
that's what
Chernobyl.
They call it.
This looks like a canyon area. Why would you install solar panels in a canyon? Oh well. I'm not a solar engineer.
The other sun doesn't eat it.
Okay, so we got an F-14A tornado. And that'd be a tornado. FA-18.
Wait, there aren't... Wait, come on, there aren't two suns, there's only one. Oh my god. It got eight.
Yeah, it got it. Eat the sun.
FA-18. Let's see what it's. Whoops. Sub-weapons. Okay, long range air to surface, advanced medium range. Oh. The other one is an unguided bomb, but advanced medium range. That'll be useful. Destroy all indicator turrets.
Use the solar panels as markers and proceed due north to the power plant. Keep an eye on those bandits.
By the way, Shaq is only used for ground targets, not air targets. Does anybody know it's used for air targets?
Say your prayers.
Dennis Rodman?
Yep, it's a nice one.
Box 2. Lead them to me. Bandit at 12 o'clock.
Is there Dennis Rodman?
I'm going with that one. Good answer!
This isn't Price is Right. Or, you know, Family Feud.
That is what you do on Price is Right.
It's like, those family members hesitate. They know it's a terrible answer, but they have to be supportive. So they're always like, good answer, good answer.
Good answer?
Anyway, it's Splash. Ground targets is Shaq, air targets is Splash.
Shaq and Splash are my favorite 80s wrestling team, tag team.
Not mine. They were too flash in the pan.
He's coming this way. Abandoned at 12 o'clock. Locked on.
Flash in the pan for my second favorite.
I got him in my sights. There they are.
They'd be like super old.
I just pictured the outfit of a wrestler called The Pan.
Are you thinking like Pure? Like, what are you?
Who's standing next to a person who is flat? A luchador mask, but it's just a cast iron thing.
Yeah, I mean, solar power generator plant. That has been done, sort of.
Wait. Miles. They're coming in fast.
Locked on. Bandits in gun range. I'll take this one. Keep going straight.
We haven't even gotten to the target yet.
Bandit at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, there you go, boots.
Obvious one, Fox one.
Ooh. Who's this fella?
Is this from Street Fighter?
Yeah, yep. I was about to say, I was like, wait.
Stupid enough to be Street Fighter.
His abs are ridiculous, and he's got black flames coming out of him. This has to be Street Fighter.
Yes, he is a luchador who is really into cooking.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Enemy facility destroyed.
Now we're getting, speaking of anime, now we're getting into Food Wars. What's up?
This cake's so good, it exploded in my bed.
Enemy facility
that's,
destroyed.
That, yeah, that's... That's not an inaccurate description of Food Wars.
I'm getting the flag from these guys.
Spit.
Die, you SOB!
I like how he doesn't actually cuss in his radio.
Die, you SOB! It's too bad your guy's silent. He'd be like, "What? I don't get it. What does that stand for?"
Sob?
Enemy facility destroyed.
Superb on battlefield, yes I am.
Just constant sass mouth.
Some love. Well, you're a silly old buffoon.
I'm not a silly old buffoon, how dare you? I'll shoot you out of the sky.
Grandpa Sky Murder was the other guy.
That's true. That's how he got his start. That's when he experienced his first Sky Murder.
Yeah, I always remember your first Sky Murder.
Grandpa, can you tell me the story of your first Sky Murder? Oh, there have been so many.
Oh no, everyone in that conversation will be talking very much like a poem. Peak poetry.
Grandpa, what awaits upon the wings of destiny?
Fox two. There he goes.
Now I'm talking like an Ace Combat character.
Yeah, now you're Ace Combat.
Enemy facility destroyed.
Or maybe he would insist that they call him Grandpa and then, like, whatever his 15 last names were.
Box two.
Oh, yeah.
Box one,
ultra
box
hyphenated
one.
15 name.
Well, son, I would have followed the wings of my soul had they not been clipped and put in the cage of war.
Yeah.
Missile hit.
Alright, I think I need to crash.
Oh, don't say that in this stream.
No, don't say that on Ace Combat, oh no.
Because I've been shot down by Square.
Oh no. Well, that's good.
Well, you know what, Boots? You're my favorite silly old buffoon.
You hit me with your
best shot.
Your sleepy ammo. There's incendiary ammo, and then there's sleepy ammo.
Fox 2.
Yeah, I researched it at Outer Heaven, and now I use it to capture new employees.
My way.
Farewell, friends.
Goodbye, Boots.
Hey, Boots.
Thanks for stopping by.
Yes.
Best of luck with the remainder of your combats.
Yay.
I'm sure to ace it.
Enemy facility.
Aha. That's how words work.
Bye.
All right,
bye.
Moves.
lot of gun food.
Oh no.
Put them metal hot dogs in.
AA guns destroyed.
Proper feeding and care of your gun.
Enemy facility destroyed.
Guess what, you beat Bloodstained, right?
Yes.
I have not.
I've
been busy. I've been playing it.
Cortez is so mad she's powering up.
That's true. Yeah, I've been busy. Regardless.
Fox 2, Fox 2.
Okay.
Missile hit. Enemy facility destroyed.
Got the DLC. DLC is also.
I didn't know it was already up. Okay. The DLC is.
Well, one of apparently 13 DLCs.
Ooh.
I got the Igas DLC.
Yeah.
Enemy facility destroyed.
Is there more than that?
There's going to be more in the future. Not currently.
Fox 2, Fox 2.
Yeah, so you played the PC one. I gotta say, I mean, the Switch version was fun. It's a good video game. But good god, is it ugly.
I mean,
it's an ugly video game.
I mean, you're not wrong, but I could forgive the visual stuff. I mean, it didn't really bother me, but just the loading times is what really killed me. Like, it's just, ugh, it takes a while to
head south to exit combat area. 2,000 feet? What do they expect us to do, go underground? Head toward the ravine and terrain mask. Use the defenses. Get low and stay low. What are you talking about? It's suicide to fly into that ravine.
No, we can't go in that ravine. It's scary in there. Oh no, you're up in.
To lower altitude. Thanks for the save.
Okay. I'm below 2,000.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Impact. Several aircraft didn't make it. Halo 7 is incommunicado. Halo 10 is down. What power? Omega 1. Stonehenge detected. 10 seconds to impact.
Oh, this is Stonehenge. I missed that.
Five.
Yeah, this is before
four,
Stonehenge
three,
fell into disrepair.
Two,
I think it, I think you like assaulted in one of the missions. I forget one of the games you attack it in.
I remember in 7, it was like your base, like you were defending yourself at Stonehenge, right?
Well, in 7, it was derelict, and you were trying to boot it back up to shoot down the
What were you saying, Bortek?
Oh, I was just saying, I like the thing, they're like, no, you can't go to the ravine, it's suicide. Just like, this is Ace Combat, we fly.
We have entire missions dedicated to flying through the ravines.
Succeeded, but the combat losses due to Stonehenge were higher than expected. Victory will elude us until it is eliminated.
Oh, is this a game where we go after Stonehenge?
At some point, I realized my uncle, my would-be guardian, had vanished. Maybe the secret police dragged him off for some drunken comment he made. Maybe he chose to disappear. I didn't have anyone to turn to, so I found myself living as if I were a member of the Yellow Squadron. Everybody in town scorned the barkeep for doing business with the enemy. In reality, he and his family were members of the resistance, gathering up intelligence information from enemy customers. His daughter protected me. But that was only because of my tender age. The barkeep and his family were the real heroes, while I, on the other hand, found a haven among the enemy.
To support our mainland operations. The Erusians responded by deploying a large number of their air superiority fighters to prevent the launch. A large-scale air battle is expected. We must win this battle to maintain our air superiority. We only got one window of opportunity for this launch. Shoot down as many fighters as possible to preserve top cover over the rocket base.
What are we buying?
I don't know. I think I'll save my money. I'll go with the Hornet again. These advanced medium range air missiles. Score at least 800 points within the time limit. Okay?
Repairing, engage.
Attention all aircraft. This is Commander Base. This rocket launch is critical. Maintain air superiority until launch is complete.
Mobius 1, engage.
L9, engage. Raider 12, engage. How many did the yellows get? Private plane was shot down by a...
Come on, missiles. Direction they're going before I shoot the missiles.
A lot of little plane chips, plane tortilla chips, on the bottom
left. Yeah.
It's like what a fancy plane chip. The nacho cheese is worth more.
Dorito orgy.
Watch out for those spicy nachos. They're on tail. I was thinking like one of fancy places, like the different colored tortilla chips. I mean, they're all just like plain tortilla chips, but they're like blue and
yeah.
This is Kamuna Base. This rocket launch is critical. Maintain
Joe
your
says the soundtrack is something else. I agree. Very good.
Yeah, all the Ace Combat's got really good music. Well, all the more recent ones, all worth checking out.
Yeah, after you played Ace Combat 7, I remember like when I was doing something where I just wanted music on in the background, didn't want lyrics or whatever, I would play a bunch of songs from Ace Combat 7. It's good stuff. I think it was Archange, and what was the one, I forget which one played when you were liberating that country.
Started over because the yellow aircraft, like the members of Yellow Squadron, are worth more, but you spend a lot of time trying to hit them, and time is of the essence.
Yeah, there's Arcane, Daredevil, and Battle for Farbanti are three of my favorite tracks from 7.
Oh, yeah, Farbanti, that's the one that takes place at, like, sunset the city.
Yeah, that's where you're, like, liberating. Yeah, you're liberating it from the, I think, is it the Usians, or who are the people, like, one of the...
Oceans?
Oceans, yeah, the Oceans. Yeah.
It's easy to remember... It's easier to remember in Ace Combat 6 because they're the Estabakians. Swing around to the cluster of enemies here. Where are they? Are they above me? Oh, they're super high. It's like a fur ball is a dogfight with a lot of planes involved.
Oh, a fur ball? That makes some sense.
And a dogfight where the planes are extremely close together and like constantly within gun range is called a night fight.
Says, I prefer the more technical term.
It's to do.
I better not see any fratricide. Radar lock.
Roust about.
A row. Hullabaloo.
Snap, buddy.
That's just online.
Missile head. All right, here we go. Omega 11 was
an S rank in this mission. Close to everyone being a real dogfight? Probably between 20 and 10 miles. And then once you get within 10 miles, then they start turning. It starts becoming a turning battle. I mean, it's kind of like Call of Duty, where you're fighting at extremely close ranges all the time, and Ace Combat's kind of like that. Where in real life, these planes would never, especially this number of planes, would ever get this close. It's like, this is like World War II stuff right here. Guy just going apeshit on the guitar.
He's in the other airplane chasing you. I think we made that joke for 7 too, but I'm gonna stick with it.
What, like Mad Max Fury Road?
Yes, there.
Guy standing up. Yeah.
Holy moly! You must need special weapons or something to get out of sea. About out of time.
Missile in.
Oh.
Sky Eye here.
One more time.
Dude, failing. So good.
Intercept them before they reach the launch site. Negative contact. Nothing on my radar. Look harder. The B-2s are difficult to detect on radar. Wow. They're stealth.
West. Okay, back to the guitar song.
We now return you to the guitar cell, already in progress.
Oh, he's XJ. Yeah, he's playing a mixtape. That's why your guy never talks. Music would carry over the radio rather than embarrassing.
What about that pilot? Well, he never talks, but he does jam out pretty well, so.
Nine missiles left. Don't know if that's going to be enough to get me to S rank. But let's see.
I believe in you. And also plane. But mainly you.
Even your plane.
Radar lock.
I don't know why, if it's the cadence, so that said, it's like, okay, you need you, and you need mouth.
Locked on. Fox 2.
Oh, for that one episode, yeah.
Yeah, for the spells one. So it's like, you need plane.
That would be a good opening for like an Ace Combat, like, I think he's
I guess you need to get 3,000 points. S rank. I don't have enough time to rearm.
Radar lock. Shot
one missile left, and then it's just guns.
Locked on. Out of missiles.
Oh, I got him! Haha, jousted him.
Nice.
Woo-hoo. So I'll just shoot my guns at these guys. Got no more weapons. Definitely hurt rounds here.
2 minutes to lunch.
Gosh. My special weapons were not as reliable.
Final launch checks complete. Launch in 60 seconds.
Well, I may as well go back to the exit because I can't fight anymore.
Can't you rearm and refuel with the power of these sick guitar licks?
Negative.
That's all I need.
30 seconds to launch. Max power! Got him.
Max power!
That's right, whoa!
15 seconds to launch. All ISAF aircraft and vehicles flow to safe area. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
I guess I'll
start
stay
ignition.
Play area.
3. 2, 1, ignition, liftoff.
Whoa!
All right!
Yeah!
All systems are in the green. Thanks to you, the launch was a success.
I probably could have watched it if I was over the, like, the central area.
The rocket launch proceeded smoothly, and all systems are go. Preparations for providing our troops with fire.
Look at all that.
Oh god, arrows everywhere!
It's a spaghetti dogfight.
Ribbons.
But it's nice to see you fought in the early Daily Show logo animation.
Yeah. I wonder if I got a ribbon for this fight.
It won't be long now. It won't be long till it begins. The barkeep's daughter confided to me. As a member of the Resistance, she eagerly awaited the Allied counterattack on the mainland. What will happen to these people when the Allies come? I asked, to which she frowned. We'll run them out. This is our town. But I knew she didn't mean that from the bottom of her heart. 13 had captured her heart. I knew this from the way she shot jealous glances at his wingmen. As other pilots rotated out of Yellow Squadron, Yellow 4, 13's wingman, always stuck by his side, even on land. The only female pilot in the squadron, she had Yellow 13's absolute trust as his wingman. Yellow 13 seemed oblivious to all this, and instead reviewed the promising enemy pilot's performance from yesterday's skirmish. He's so close. If he manages to stay alive for just a while longer, that pilot could be a worthy opponent. But when there were no such enemies to look forward to...
There you go, Extra.
Yep.
13's eyes were sad.
Felix just says, angst, angst, angst!
Alright, folks, that's gonna do it for tonight.
Well, that was good stuff.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, thank you.
Good airplaning.
Thank you all for joining me. I'll plan on being back the Thursday evening, same time, to reclaim to continue from this point forward. Everybody have a good night, and I will catch you all later.
Good night, everybody.
Good night. To the inland objective. This path allows